In this episode of Taskmaster, contestants have 20 minutes to rearrange the letters on this bunting to make a stirring speech. And the speech that uses the most letters wins.
Sir, on my knee, I implore you, please, let me win this task.
Dad.
The contestants didn't use things like computers, smartphones, or dictionaries, and it made me wonder if Taskmaster is all about finding creative, out-of-the-box approaches to completing the tasks, then if you had unlimited time and access to a computer, could you come up with some sort of elegant way to complete this task? Could it help you write a better speech, and could you maybe even use every letter provided, something that none of the contestants managed to do? So I wrote a program just to solve this problem. I am going to show you how it works and the optimization I found to make it run super fast. And at the end, I'll show you the speech I wrote using the same letters as the contestants in Taskmaster. In a typical anagram solver like Scrabble Word Finder, you input the letters available to you, let's call that the letter pool, and it suggests words that can be spelled with some or all of those letters. But for this Taskmaster task, ideally there should also be a feature where you can type a draft of your speech. So as you're writing, it takes those letters out of the letter pool and automatically updates the word suggestions based on the remaining letters. So that's what I made, you're looking at it right now, but it runs pretty slowly. Here's why. For each of the 200,000 English words in the word list I downloaded, it pre-calculates a letter frequency table for each one. In other words, it tallies up the letters in the word. In JavaScript code, that looks like this, but let's just visualize it as an actual table. And the program cross-compares that with a letter frequency table for the letter pool. It checks each quantity of letters in the word to see if it's less than or equal to the corresponding quantity of letters in the letter pool. If so, then the word is spellable and it will be suggested. That means the program is doing 26 comparisons for each of the 200,000 words, which is over 5 million comparisons total every time the user makes a change to their draft. That's a lot of work, so right now the program is often taking over 100 milliseconds to generate the word list, which isn't terrible, but it's slow enough that it can't really keep up with fast typing speeds. We could make it a lot better. That was a lot of information, so before we continue, let's look at this cat. Okay, here's how we're going to optimize the algorithm. For now, let's not worry about quantities of letters. We'll just try to make the program suggest words that have the correct letters, even if they're in the wrong quantities. So instead of tallying up letters and making letter frequency tables, we'll create tables of Boolean values, or true-false values, just to indicate whether each letter of the alphabet is present in the word or not. Imagine we have this letter pool. If we cross-compare each word's Boolean table with the letter pool's Boolean table to confirm that the word has the correct letters of the alphabet, then words like bagged will be suggested even though they need a greater quantity of certain letters than the letter pool provides. But we'll fix that a little later. The reason we're doing this is because there's actually a way we can make the program cross-compare all 26 Boolean values at once instead of one at a time, which would be way more efficient. It works like this. Instead of Boolean values, we can use a sequence of ones and zeros, where one represents true and zero represents false. And we'll keep these digits in alphabetical order so we know which digit corresponds to what letter of the alphabet. The result is a binary number. We could also call this a bit field since we're not really using it to represent an actual number. The bit field for each word can be cross-compared with the bit field for the letter pool using bitwise operations, which are operations that computers do to compare binary numbers super fast and efficiently. Specifically, it's looking for any cases where the word has a letter that the pool doesn't have. So it's looking for cases where a 1 is above a 0. For this, we can use the AND and NOT operations because we're looking for digits where the word's bit field has a 1 and the pool's bit field does not have a 1. In all the spots where that's the case, the output will be a 1, and everywhere else there'll be a 0. So if the output is all zeros like here, then the program has failed to find any cases where the pool was missing a letter that the word required, so the word will be suggested. Conversely, if the word does have a letter that the pool doesn't have, like this K, then there'll be a 1 above a 0, and the output will produce a 1 in that spot. And if the output has any 1s in it at all, then the word must be unspellable. So to summarize so far, all 200,000 words in the word list, as well as the letter pool, now have pre-calculated bit fields that use 26 ones and zeros to represent which letters of the alphabet are present. By using bitwise operations, the computer compares all 26 digits against each other at once instead of separately. And these comparisons are also really fast because computers are fast at bitwise operations. Okay, let's look at that cat again. Great. So like I said earlier, this new algorithm suggests words that have the right letters but in the wrong quantities. That's because the only information stored in these bit fields is whether or not the word has at least one occurrence of each letter of the alphabet. To fix this, we can just add more bit fields that indicate whether the word has at least 2 occurrences of every letter and at least 3 occurrences, etc. I used 9 bit fields because the words in my English word list have no more than 9 occurrences of a single letter. Each of these bit fields is cross-compared with its corresponding bit field in the letter pool. If all these comparisons yield no issues, then the word must be spellable. But if any one of them does, the word must be unspellable. In theory, this does mean we're doing 9 times as many comparisons as earlier, but these comparisons are so fast that it actually makes a negligible difference. Also, once the program finds a bit field that confirms the word is unspellable, it doesn't need to bother checking the rest. Usually, the program can tell when a word is unspellable after checking just 1 or 2 bit fields. And that's pretty much it. With this method, the program can usually produce word suggestions in around 20 milliseconds, or 0.02 seconds. That's about 5 times faster, which is more than fast enough for our needs. So how effective is this at helping you write the speech for Taskmaster? Well, as a point of comparison, here's the winning speech from the episode.
A. Hi, Taskmaster. I don't like you looking happy. I dare. Don't vex me. End.
The speech used 61 out of 72 characters, or 85%. Most contestants used some clever ideas to work around the limited letter pool. Judy Love borrowed an E from Taskmaster to put it somewhere else, used a period as an O, and used an exclamation point as an X. And some contestants flipped M's to make W's. I transcribed the speeches to accurately reflect the characters that were actually used, and if you look closely, you'll notice that I have too much free time. Now, in the episode, there were flags with punctuation on them, but my program only supports letters. It ignores any punctuation you type. But I think that's okay because this is a creative task, there are no rules, and most speeches didn't use proper punctuation anyway. With that in mind, I made 3 different speeches using the same letter pool that's in Taskmaster. All of these speeches use every letter, and I guess you can tell me how you think they hold up in terms of creativity.
Taskmaster. Challenges, dedication, trophies. I'm moving up a rank, okay? Imped, I find a way.
And this next one is about me using the program.
Spark, stimulate the mind. I, Faker, can simply overdesign a word processor. Ah, imagination docked.
Here's one about the optimization.
With a little drop of ingenuity, skimming a search space improved. A Sandman. Die. Back.
That's the sound of me killing a sandman because I stay up too late doing these projects. Using every available character while keeping it coherent is pretty tricky even with the help of this program, but it's also a pretty fun puzzle. It makes me have a greater appreciation for Judy's ability to use 85% of the characters in just 20 minutes without a computer or even a pencil and paper from the looks of it. And of course, as with any good Taskmaster task, Alex revealed at the end that the best solution was right under the contestants' noses the entire time.
There is one other thing. Everyone struggled a little bit with the letters provided. People questioned the lack of Bs. These are obviously the letters here. Nobody worked out why those letters were provided. Any thoughts, Greg?
The red flags?
Exactly. If they looked at the red flags, you see it says, look under the desk.
Hello! Welcome at last to Taskmaster. I'm Greg Davis, and I am the Taskmaster. I'm powerful and in peak physical condition.
That is, of course, the most stirring speech in all Taskmaster history, and we did provide all the letters for that and an extra K because we got it slightly wrong.
Since they accidentally added that extra K, I'm pretty sure that means that I score 101.4% for including it in my speech. Here's another writing challenge. We can take anagrams that other people have come up with on the internet and expand on them. For example, a popular anagram of a decimal point is I'm a dot in place. But I also came up with am located in pi. A popular anagram of the Morse code is here come dots. And I came up with remote docs, eh? Because it's remote communication, that's probably a stretch. And finally, there are two popular anagrams of William Shakespeare. There's I am a weakish speller and I'll make a wise phrase. And in addition to those, I came up with I spake real lies, wham! This is harder than it looks. I should mention that the idea to use bitfields was inspired by a video by Matt Parker where he attempts to solve a Wordle-related puzzle with code. His viewers had the idea to optimize the code with bitfields to indicate which letters of the alphabet are present in each word so they could take advantage of those really fast bitwise operations. And they used lower-level languages like Rust and C++. I used JavaScript, which is a higher-level language, as you can see in this ancient graphic, so it's not exactly ideal for bitwise operations. There seems to be varying opinions online about how fast bitwise operations really are in JavaScript, so maybe it wasn't the best tool to use here, but from my research I decided it was at least worth a try, and it seemed to work pretty well. I should also mention that there are other optimizations I could have made that I didn't bother with, such as categorizing words by what letters they have so the program doesn't have to search the entire word list every time. It just didn't feel necessary because 20 milliseconds is already so fast that it basically feels instant, so I'm happy with it. And lastly, I'd love to see what you can create with this program. You can try it right now at the link in the description, or just visit my website. It's just a web page, so it'll work on whatever device you're using to watch this. You can set the letter pool to be whatever you want, of course, but it comes pre-filled with the letter pool from the Taskmaster task, so you can try the challenge yourself and leave a comment with what you come up with. Thanks.
Thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Back.